Mr. Cranston, morning.
Good morning.
The script, what was it? You said that the script kind of blew your mind. What was it about the script that really kind of captured your imagination?
I think at first I was thinking that this was going to be just a monster movie, and it really isn't. And the thing that iced it for me as far as wanting to be a part of it was that it has a very strong character-driven narrative to it. Husband, wife, father, son, multi-generational. And I thought that was very clever. And I've always thought, why not? Why can't you meld those? Because you have the great, epic, iconic battles with monsters in a monster movie. And then you also have this group of people that you follow and care about and root for. And you can have it all. And it dovetailed very nicely into this movie. I always hearken back to the first one I ever saw from 1954. I was a huge Godzilla fan as well. In fact, I had the little figurines of Godzilla, and I would go into my mother's kitchen and get cups and bowls and things and fill them with dirt and glasses with dirt, and I'd turn them upside down to make molds to make my own little city. You know, and then my Godzilla would come through and crash through the whole thing. I just loved it. So that was, I remember the Raymond Burr version of it, you know, when they inserted him into the Japanese movie. And later on, when I realized how they actually came about doing that, I thought that was very clever. So by doing that, though, it made it a universal appeal to it. And so it wasn't just in the Japanese market, but it created a fervor throughout the world. There have been some other films that have come along that have been, you know, a measured degree of success, but I think I'm really happy with this one because of the fact that we really took the time to invest in the characters. And in a way, you could actually, if you just took the storyline of the characters, you could have like a separate movie in and of itself. It could be that they're fighting to get back and reunite in their family. But to have both, I think, makes the experience more rewarding. It's easy to, I mean, I am a father, so it's easy to roll into that. He's a father, too, so it's easy for that relationship to take place. You know, when you sign on to do a piece like this, you really are looking at the material. You talk to the director, you agree to it, and then you hope that when you get on the set that you'll make a connection. It's not imperative that you do, but the fact that we got along and like each other just made it easier to meld into that relationship.
Although we have this kind of feud, you know, and I'm supposed to be angry at him all the time, although he'd be cracking jokes a lot, so, you know, I can't be stay angry at Brian.
And
so
he acted like my son. I would say something and he would roll his eyes and like, oh, great. The general disrespect for the elderly.
Initially, the motion capture was all done by Brian Cranston. And after a few test screenings, we felt Godzilla was a little bit camp.
I thought it was good. Little Bob Fosse.
Jazz hands Godzilla, that I want to see.
Yeah. I've got a question from my 9-year-old son, Hag, who loved the film, by the way. His question is, to all of you, if you came home, turned on the TV, and your local town was being attacked by monsters, what would be the first thing you'd do?
Good question.
I would call my mother, just to make sure that she was capable of exiting her own home.
I'd make a sandwich and watch the play unfold. Like a sporting event.
Thomas?
Maybe I'd call Brian and ask if I could come over and have a sandwich and Watch it, maybe.
You gotta see this, man. It's great. We're all gonna die anyway. Come on.
It's HD.
Aaron?
I really can't follow.
Okay. Should we leave it there then? Let's leave it there then. Okay.
Brian, you have a very long list of credits, film and TV credits, but it seems that since Breaking Bad, your celebrity status has reached new levels. And my question is, how has your life and career changed since this enormous success?
I was dubbed the new darling of Hollywood, just like Elizabeth was. You know, an actor really is only hoping for opportunity. And we've been very fortunate on this dais to be able to have that come to us. And if that's what stardom means, then I accept that. You know, that's what it means to me, that I can work on a greater level of material and to be able to have more say in what we do. When you first start out as an actor, if your agent calls you and says they'd like you to do, you say yes before they're finished with what project it was, because you need the job. And so that's why, you know, when you first start out, you have a lot of product on there that you've done that you're not particularly proud about, but it everything was a stepping stone to get to an opportunity where you can then have more control of your own destiny. So, but the other thing is that, you know, for Breaking Bad or whatever movie, or Kick-Ass, or you don't really know how it's going to be received. You do a project in a bubble, and you like the work, you like the people you're working with, and you hope for the best. And Breaking Bad became this, you know, this larger-than-life mushroom cloud that none of us could have anticipated. We're very grateful for it, but it's certainly not something that we were working toward that becoming. It's the public, it's the fans that create a classic film or television show. It's up to them to decide if it weathers the test of time. And so too will be this version of our film. You know, in time, people will look back and say that Godzilla of 2014 was fantastic, except for a couple of the direction. You know, they'll say it was great. Thank you, though.